afternoon and a very warm welcome to you. My name is Jeannie D. This is Afternoon Express and it's so good to be back. Indeed. I've missed you. It feels like I've been gone for ages.
We've been checking out the journey online. Don't you worry. We go check from Afternoon Express to watching Presenter Search. And you luckily were pretty kind this year. I was very impressed.
Oh, well, I'm very pleased to be here. Now, this afternoon, we're going to smooth your way into the weekend with one of the most prolific jazz artists of this generation.
Indeed. But before we get into that, can we just take a moment for last night's finale of Presenter Search on Three? Man.
How's that for a
finale? How crazy is that drama at the end? I think you guys must have had the toughest job, I think, in television history, is to choose between such amazing talents, and you couldn't.
So if you didn't watch last night, it was incredible. We had a top six. We were meant to go down to a top three, but we threw in a little loophole.
A little twist, and three others got jobs as well. We'll be joining them. Well, a new colleague will be joining us on the show as well on Monday. So looking forward to spending some time with her as well on Afternoon Express, plus all the other talent that's going to be across SABC3. It's going to be fantastic. Absolutely. Open up the industry.
The talent this year was absolutely incredible and all so deserving. So now make sure you head over to our social media platforms and let us know who inspired you this week. Tweet us at Afternoon Chat using the official hashtag Afternoon Express or comment on our Facebook page. Now, as we get to inspiration, jazz isn't just a bunch of notes constructed to form a tune. It's a story first created in the heart and inspired by the most intimate parts of a person's soul. So jazz music is a language, sometimes delicate, often boisterous, but always layered with experience and life profoundly lived.
Indeed, beautifully said. Nduduzo carries the torch for the current generation of young South African jazz musicians. His music can be described as transcendent, and this is obviously attributed to the quality of his work that earned him the respect and camaraderie among notable peers and jazz legends.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much.
What an honor to finally have you here.
Yes.
I'm honored to be here. Thank you.
Your work is just so beautiful. And for somebody who, for me, I'm an absolute music lover, I find jazz such a personal kind of genre.
Yeah.
Because it's, for somebody to appreciate it, you've got to understand the artist, I think, because it's such
sure.
it's such a great arrangement.
Yeah.
And there's so many different kinds of jazz.
Yeah.
What is your, if somebody had to ask you to describe jazz in your style, how would you break it down to somebody to want them to become a fan?
For me, it's a collective memory. It's the story that we share that manifests in sort of sonic experiences, but it's not as complex as people think it is.
Yeah.
It's just that allowing of yourself to dissolve in a particular story. Yeah. That's really what it is, and I'm more fascinated by the sort of healing properties of jazz, so which are really borrowed from even pre-colonial musics of Africa, you know what I mean? So I borrow certain things from jazz, but I wouldn't entirely call my music jazz, but it's a music that carries healing properties, and through improvisation that is associated with jazz, then I'm able to explore beyond normal.
That really fascinates me because as I said just now, I'm such a music lover, and I love that you went on to healing properties of it. Now, sonar healing is so powerful.
Sure.
Like, I read that when choir boys sing at the same time and they hit a perfect level of harmony, their hearts start beating at exactly the same time.
Oh, yeah.
So what are your healing properties of jazz? Like, what is your connection, and what do you think is the effect on people?
So I believe that jazz or the music that I produce is connected to another realm where our ancestors are believed to live. Mm. Some people say abaphansi, some people say the underworlds. But I think music as a whole, there is a music that has no performer, that is constantly happening. Yeah. And I think my kind of music is the music that strikes those parallels or evokes the other music that exists anyway. So it's not really about the music, but about connecting to the greater music of the spheres. You know, some people have referred to it, like Mamle Tambuli, as there's a beautiful song she wrote called Music in the Air, so to speak. So I'm just a messenger that taps into those musics.
And, isn't it misconceived, ubungoma? Like, ubungoma is quite, like, misconceived in terms of its way that it's understood in African tradition and African culture, especially, like, leaking into the world of music that's so rich in our nation and sub-Saharan Africa. And what does ubungoma mean to you, then?
Yeah, ubungoma, I mean, there's a couple of ways to look at it. First, ubungoma is that process of becoming isangoma. Isangoma will be then your traditional healer. But if you zoom into the word itself, it's the process of becoming. And ngoma means song. You know, so it's that process of allowing yourself to be driven by something. Like a song doesn't necessarily choose what direction it goes. So it's really to be that messenger that really is open to new directions and open to being instructed from higher realms. So ubungoma is, I mean, most the conventional way, so to speak, is through wetwasa. And there is not just one mode of wetwasa. Wetwasa is the process of becoming isangoma. Some people go underneath water. Some people go and spend time with an older sangoma and through an initiation process. But some people also find it in their dreams. And this is really what's been my biggest sort of fascination. It's like, you know, the other realms that exist and being given an opportunity to tap into those via dreams, via visions, and via improvised music. Quite recently, I was performing a gig and in the middle of this particular song, I had called this gig Umsamu. Umsamu is a sacred space at which the ancestors are believed to reside in a homestead. So I thought, okay, this is a good theme to sort of reimagine performance space and start thinking about what sort of other existence or what projections do take place during that performance. And during that performance, an older grandmother of mine that I had not seen in years emerged. And it's such a difficult thing to start explaining. So part of my writing is towards that. How do we then start building a language? How do we speak about these things in a way that is not judged, especially in academic writing, which is so Western?
Do you feel that a lot of people aren't connected? That, like, you've obviously got an extreme awareness to what's happening around you.
Yeah.
And, I mean, when did you first realize that you were so, I suppose, aware of what was happening around you? Because a lot of people don't see it, and then they struggle to feel it. So then how do they understand that with your music? How do you connect them?
I think it's a lot of stages. For me, I was first introduced to music as a mode for transcendence. This is from the Zionist church. My grandmother used to heal people and she used water. Through water that was believed to code certain information and carried sort of like healing properties. And this is something that I carried as well when I started performing. I remember, I think it was 2014 when I started recording the album called Listening to the Ground, and Listening to the Ground was really about that process of, you know, the whole notion of God in the sky versus African notions of the ground and maybe our symbolism to land, and maybe further linking to why people want their land. It's not really a sort of commercialized idea, but it's that of Inkaba, you know, it's that of we believe that our people, when they die, they go to the ground. But that also links to how then I think about my creative process as well. So ubungoma is very central in my process, in that it allows me that sort of space where one can start connecting, not just myself, but also I believe that audiences that experience my music stand a chance to connecting to unlocking their dreams and that sort of thing. So it goes beyond the music itself. Music is just a platform at which we could start thinking about these narratives, but it's important as well to locate them in our history, especially sort of looking at pre-colonial histories. Because I think through Christianity, although I draw a lot from Christianity, but a lot of the things were lost or were replaced by this new sort of mode of belief system that was introduced to African people.
Your process and obviously your connection and then the way that you share that is so fascinating to me. I want to chat to you a little bit more about that later, and also the impact and the relevance of water with how you perform. So we're going to chat about that a little bit later.
Summer awards and all that stuff. There's lots to get through on the show today. We'll be back more with Nduduzo after the break. Plus, we head to the kitchen. Chef Clem will be showing us how to take a chocolate Super M to that next level.
And remember to join the conversation online and let us know who inspired you this week. Tweet us at Afternoon Chat using the official hashtag Afternoon Express or comment on our Facebook page. Express
yourself. Stand a chance of following in the footsteps of your favorite presenter Search on 3 contestant by winning a trip for two to Reunion Island. Spend 7 nights in 5-star luxury at the Akoya Hotel and Spa, including economy flights from Joburg on Air Austral and car rental for a week, all courtesy of the Reunion Tourism Board. To stand a chance of winning, tell us where the Presenter Search on 3 finale was held. Was it 1, Reunion Island, or 2, Mauritius? SMS the keyword Reunion plus your name, city and answer, 1 or 2, to 33728. That's 33728 at R1.50 per SMS. No free SMSs apply. Entrants must be over 18 and hold a valid South African passport. T's and C's apply and can be found on presentersearchon3.com.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. Now, it's the last day of the Computex competition, and to enter the competition today, you could walk away with an awesome prize from Computex, including a designer handbag, luxurious spa voucher, 2,000 Rand cash, and a Computex hamper to the total of 5,000 Rand. SMS WIN to 33650, VAS rates apply, T's and C's do apply, and visit afternoonexpress.co.za for more details.
Made with love by Clover.
Now it is the weekend and Afternoon Express wants to get you ready. If you've had one of those crazy weeks, those busy weeks, and you're looking for something to just chill, we've got the solution for you. And did you know that you can hashtag try it hot with Clover Super M? Well, then join us as we take a moment in between all this madness that you've had this week to just chill with a Super M ultimate hot chocolate. It's a recipe not to be missed. SMS the keyword Clover to 33650 at a cost of 1 rand 50. It'll be sent directly to your device. You just sit back, relax, and enjoy. Let's get started.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Pan on. So a few weeks ago, I said that you can make hot chocolate with butter. All right.
Okay.
That's my special ingredient.
Butter, why would you do that?
Why not? You put butter in everything. Okay, cool. So
butter makes it better. You've told me
really
this many
does,
times
really
in the show.
So here's the thing. You know, you add salt to chocolate. It brings out the flavor of chocolate, making it a better drink.
Chili to chocolate as well. Brings out the flavor of the chocolate.
Absolutely. Butter's got salt in it, right? So why not just add the butter to the hot chocolate?
And it adds that whole like creaminess of the butter.
And then it coats your lips. And you're just like, are you a genius? Yes,
you thought, you thought our jazz artist in the show today was a genius. You're a genius in this kitchen.
I'm trying. It's really crazy, but it works. Okay, cool. Super M chocolate going in. Some extra chocolate chips. Because we want to make it extra chocolatey.
Is it those dark chips?
They are dark. Nice, nice combination of bitter and the normal flavor of the milk chocolate.
No, you want the richness of a dark chocolate.
You
What's the
need
point of
that
a hot
richness.
Chocolate without the richness?
Absolutely. So in goes the butter. Don't look at how much I'm putting in. Just look away. Look away.
Look away.
Cool.
It's all about the flavor in the end, right?
You know what? It's a really decadent, I would say this as a dessert. It's something at the end of a meal that's quite rich, but it works. It really works. So heat up, just like that. Let me see what we're doing. Cool. Then the idea is that we're going to aerate it. We're going to whip the butter through the chocolate. I feel bad even just saying this.
No, don't say bad. It feels bad at all. I mean, the thing is about these treats is that don't try and expect yourself to try and pretend like it's not decadent, delicious, and yummy. And it's all about trying to say, like, I've had a hard week and I just want to indulge. Just indulge.
Exactly.
Don't lie to yourself.
It's really good. It's really, really good. So if you, okay, if you're a grown-up, you're an adult, you add a little bit of Irish cream to this, make it even more, you know what? But okay, so great for the kids.
T's and C's apply, kids. Do not try this at home.
No. Cool. So get your blender ready. Yeah. This part is totally optional, okay? You're doing this just to, like, incorporate that air in there, and then you aim for your co-presenter, try to get as much chocolate all over there. All right? And you're right, though, the butter melts through, makes it even thicker. It makes it more luxurious.
Oh,
you can taste the goodness. Okay, cool. Now, it's nice and frothy. Turn it down. Into Dan's little mug over here.
That's so cool.
Oh, look at it bubbling.
Wow, that's nice and warm. So the idea is, obviously, you want to be able to make this thing before bed. I mean, it's kind of the end towards winter. Save it, keep it cool, have a cool hot chocolate or like a cold chocolate later on the next day.
Exactly. Ooh, did I get you?
You got me, Clem.
That's okay, it's fine.
You got me. He got me, right?
It'll wipe away. It'll wipe away.
Now, Jeannie is going to give me trouble.
What's she going to say? A little bit of cream.
Okay, you can't do anything neat.
Well, she knows that about us. Cool, a little bit of sprinkle more chocolates. So that's the original one. Now, I want you to taste these other two that I made. Can you guess the ingredient?
No, I also can't take
it. So besides the butter, I added something else.
Oh, it's something like, it's not cinnamon, it's like a cardamom or like a nutmeg.
Nutmeg. How crazy is that?
Nice.
Okay, the next one?
Is it nutmeg?
It's nutmeg.
You're not lying to me to make me feel good.
No. It's nutmeg. This one?
Oh, wow. I actually don't know with this one. Caramel?
Cardamom. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
So the idea is that, you know, when we've got this base, this is beautiful.
Oh, wow.
And you want to spice it up a little bit, try all different flavors.
Nice. So the idea is take something that's really simple, really basic. You always love the taste of the Super M's cold. Warm it up slightly and then throw some other flavors in there. Play around, enjoy it. The idea is just to relax and enjoy the tasty and sweet treat that we made on the show today. Remember to SMS the keyword Clover to 33650. That way you'll get the recipe sent directly to your device, to a device. It will cost you 150 and your free SMSs don't apply. And I say this every single time we do the recipes. If you drool throughout this whole thing, here's a recap to remind you.
Made with Love by Clover.
That looked delicious.
Right.
Now, the song Urine Chains 2 was born when Nduduzo was invited to Stellenbosch University during the Fees Must Fall movement. And it tells the story of how everyone is a slave to something or someone at some point in their lives, and how we are all oppressed in one way or another. Beautiful. So you head up the music department at Fort Hare sure. University. I mean, what a great, legendary, iconic university to be part
of.
And what fascinates me is you can teach someone music. You can teach them the technical.
Yeah.
But you can't teach people how to be a great musician. So what is that experience like for you, working with people who could become legendary like you are, and just kind of carving out that talent?
Yeah, I think for me what really is important is finding ways at which people could start linking their music studies to their cultural backgrounds.
Yeah.
And I think being in a place like the Eastern Cape, which is so packed with culture, heritage, it is important to pay attention to what you know, the backgrounds of the people are. So I find it to be easier that way, because then I introduce foreign concepts through very familiar contexts, so to speak. So it's something that I really enjoy. And now thinking back, since 2006, when I graduated at UKZN, I've always been teaching. I went to Central Johannesburg College. I taught for 2 years. Mm. After that, I was at Wits. So there's just an aesthetic to how knowledge circulation happens.
Yeah. Well, you have something, you want to share it, right? Isn't that the whole understanding?
But also the process, you end up learning more in terms of how these different students will grasp certain information. Sure. And for you to constantly be thinking about what sort of new ways you could introduce and use in order for students to really benefit from some of these teachings.
But if we take this song into context, like when you say that even the oppressors, I suppose, are oppressed at some point, to teach that way of thinking, which is completely selfless, and you're teaching people how to go within and kind of show that every man has their own cross to bear.
Yeah.
It's very forgiving and open. I mean, I would love to be in one of your classrooms to understand how you teach that.
Yeah, I think that that's something that's deeply embedded in some of the African sort of concepts. I mean, we could pick up one, Ubuntu.
Yeah.
That really says you are because of everyone that exists around you. So these sort of thinkings, whatever you do, I mean, you can go far east and think about karma, and whatever you do to someone, that someday it will come back to you. Yeah. So, I mean, these are concepts that are so ancient. It's nothing new. So the process, I'd like to believe, is that of trying to remember. It's stuff that we know, and the process with my students is to collectively, myself and the students, to try help each other to remember, as opposed to the idea of teaching as in this guy that stands in front of you and bringing all this new information, but it's like really helping each other on pathways on how we could collectively remember.
Speaking about the collective, what I find so interesting about you is your humility, and I want to keep bringing that up because I think it guides a lot of what you do, is that sort of sense of humility. And it's funny, there's always a strong female woman in somebody's life when they're this humble. And you collaborate with your grand, like you collaborate with your grandmom, I think, on some music. And your wife.
I've always been surrounded by these great women, because my dad wasn't really present most of the time. The times that he was around, it was amazing to see him make music with my mom. He was a guitarist, and my mother played the keyboards. And I remember my mom would be cooking and my dad playing the guitar, and that was the, you know, just about the only thing I happened to experience. Yeah. But then my mom is like one of the most beautiful human beings. And I think I find that sort of thing in my wife as well, who also happens to be a musician.
Oh, my word.
Yeah, so we studied music together with her, and I sort of graduated from one thing to the next, from being a sort of a classmate to maybe becoming sort of a keyboard player in the group, mm-hmm. to becoming a really close friend.
Getting closer and closer. Good job.
And to having kids together. Yeah. But she's one of the most beautiful singers we have in this country, mm-hmm. and one of the greatest composers, you know. So I'm really honored to have these people. And like you say, you can't do it alone. Mm. This collective sort of space is crucial. You know, a fertile ground, a fertile space from which to start.
Yeah, to plant those seeds.
To plant those seeds, definitely.
So are your children musical then?
Yeah, these guys are, my daughter was taking piano lessons, and I've since learned that she quit, but she's an amazing pianist. Mm. And so every time I play, she's the one that would be like correcting me about posture and stuff. Yeah. And because I started playing when I was a little old. But now my second born, Tingo, is really an amazing musician and very intuitive. Yeah. And he picks up, like before I left yesterday, he's been singing a Begim Selegu song.
That's so cool.
One of the most difficult Selegu songs to sing. And Moyo as well, my last born, is a piano player. So I think I'm surrounded by great music.
Yeah.
And also, like, I want to believe that these guys have been here before. So that same thing, I'm just guiding them towards their dreams. But it doesn't necessarily mean that, you know, this idea of a father, sometimes we, you know, we don't have a way to articulate it in ways that reflect that. In the process, we also are learning from these people. So it's not a one way.
Yeah,
again, I'm seeing so many things from them and I'm learning so many things.
Mm. Every piece of your work has got so much meaning behind it. Ikambi, tell us more.
Oh, yeah. Ikambi is a very exciting record, simply because it links to my third album, Listening to the Ground, and this journey of really trying to explore more deliberately how music can start healing people and myself. And Babum Selig would say healing the spaces that we're in. So Ikambi, I mean, loosely translated, is a healing concoction, it's a herbal concoction. Mm. So I use that to start thinking about, in this modern era, what would be the equivalent in terms of how. But also, in ancient times, there was this deliberateness in terms of song. Mm. People used to compose rain songs. So if there was a drought, like we've experienced in Cape Town, a couple of was it last year?
Yes.
Yeah, so people, the rainmakers, would go on a ritual and then it would rain. So I think with the commercialization of music, and people have started losing some of the key sort of components of why there is the process of music creation in the first place. So Ikambi tries to remember that, but also it tries to crystallize some of what it means to be black.
Yes.
And our sort of religious beliefs. For example, Umthakathi is seen as a witch doctor. Mm. A witch, actually. Mm. A witch doctor is something else, a witch. And when I grew up, everyone talked about Umthakathi, and we never really saw Umthakathi. Okay. So, but there were so many lessons to learn from these narratives, from these stories. So Ikambi also brings those stories back into like our language or languaging, our daily sort of conversations, and to rethink and think of them in this context now in a modernized society.
Sure.
You are quite like jazz. You're a fantastic storyteller.
Mm.
Thank you so much. We've got another interview with you. And of course, you're going to be performing twice on the show, so we're going to have so much more of you on this show.
It's such
a pleasure having you here.
Thank you so much.
Nduduzo is always with us for the whole show, and we'll be performing live as well. So after the break, we chat presenter search, and we have a new colleague joining us on Monday. And for anyone who missed the finale last night, stay right where you are.
Indeed. Remember that you need to add your voice to the social media sites. Who inspired you this week? At Afternoon Chat on Twitter, Afternoon Express on Facebook, and the hashtag Afternoon Express. We'll be right back.
Made with love by Clover.
From beef lasagna to creamy macaroni and cheese, Clover the Whistling Chef's high-quality, ready-to-eat meals are made using trusted Clover cheese, milk and cream. It's SA's favourite home-cooked recipes, now prepared and conveniently packed with a variety to choose from. Added to that, Africa's first vac-seal technology ensures they're kept fresher for longer for the whole family to enjoy. The Whistling Chef. Heat, whistle, eat, sing. It's as simple as that. Made with love by Clover. It's as simple as that. Made with love by Clover.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. It is a Friday, and I'm so glad that you're with us on the show today. Last night was the final episode of Presenter Search on 3, and what a nail-biter and finale it was. Most exciting for me was finally finding out that Palesa Tembe will be joining the Afternoon Express family. Now, maybe the biggest surprise was the fact that all of the six in the top six became winners and officially have careers in the media industry. And obviously, Jeannie was so involved in that process, and what a tough job you guys had to do to look through all of them, because they were so talented. Yeah.
This year was possibly the hardest year of all the presenter searches that we've ever had, because this year we had the most amount of talent. So already from our top 10, it became impossible to kind of whittle it down, I suppose, to decide.
So it was never the plan, right? It was never the plan.
The intention was for three winners. And then everyone was just so good that we had to keep everyone.
Sure, that's insane. Because going from six to sort of three, it's quite a big
would have been a huge jump and cut
to be able to make. So the talent that you guys saw clearly was amazing. Was there something in particular that this year had that the other years didn't have? Was there something like a flavor or a spark?
I don't know what it was. I mean, this year everyone was good. I mean, and it was a perfect balance because we got somebody from everywhere. There was Joburg, there was Cape Town, there was Durban, there was Eastern Cape. Everyone was involved. And there was just an extraordinary amount of talent. This year, everyone was authentic. They all took their direction well. They all grew so much. And they all were just amazing personalities and great people.
Yeah.
Like, they were just great people to work with. And, you know, when you fall in love with somebody, you just don't want to let them go.
Yes, exactly. I'm sure. And the SABC3 is going to be so blessed to have new talent and, you know, these exciting new faces join the television shows. Like, words of advice to these winners now that they've gone off into the world?
You know, the hard work starts now. I mean, the competition was really tough for them, and they must enjoy it. I think the only advice that I have to give, I suppose, is that we are in the business of fun. You've got to genuinely be enjoying what you are doing for everybody else at home to be enjoying watching you.
Awesome.
I mean, it's been an amazing experience. Everybody is so good. I just want them to enjoy the process.
Awesome. And I can't wait for Palesa to come and join the loft.
Oh, she's amazing.
And have so much fun.
I'm so obsessed with her. She's really cool. I fell in love with her from the start, and she's just so cute. Yeah. She's
and I hope amazing. You guys do too as well. On Monday, she will be joining us on Afternoon Express. We'll have all six winners in the loft. Tell us more about their experience and how they are feeling at this point, because obviously the big moments now happened. What happens next? So don't forget to tune in on Monday at 4:30 on SABC3. And if you didn't catch the finale last night, you can watch the repeat. It's going to be happening tomorrow at 12 p.m. on SABC3. It's an episode not to be missed.
If you do just one thing this year, bank better in 2018. Get the Capitec credit card with a limit of up to 150,000 rand with personalized interest from 12.9% based on your credit profile and affordability. Bank better to live better with Capitec.
We have a legend with us in the loft today on Afternoon Express to get us ready for the weekend. And as Jeannie said on the top of the show, it's going to go out in smooth style. We have the honor of witnessing Nduduzo play Ubambo, which is, means unity. And this song questions the notion of unity among all South Africans post-94 in a democratic South Africa. So don't only listen to it, but feel it.
Tell you that watching you perform is even as more beautiful than hearing you perform. Your whole body goes, wow, that was so beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Wow, what really a privilege to pull that. That was so beautiful.
Thank you.
Wow. Now make sure you stay tuned to hear Nduduzo perform again later live on the show. We are so lucky to have you here. And of course, don't forget to share your afternoon staring with us. Hashtag afternoon staring. Who is making waves this week in your circles? Tweet us at afternoon chat using the official hashtag afternoon express or comment on our Facebook page. Jesus. Welcome back to Afternoon Express. Now, what did I tell you? We are sliding your way into the weekend like it's nobody's business. Mm. What an amazing day. Now, Shwele is based on a true encounter that Nduduzo had during the tribal violence that took place in South Africa post-1994. He witnessed a young man being killed in the backyard of the house he was hiding in and was conflicted by not being able to help him, fearing for his life. Have a look at this. South Africa is still in so much need of so much healing. What prompted that? I mean, we heard part of the story, but what was your encounter?
The song is really like just one way at which we could start healing from some of these traumas, you know. And the story is around a mother who had to make one of two decisions. One, the son was dying just at the backyard, and one was to go out and stop these people, and chances are she's in a risk of dying herself. And secondly is to rather not go out and just be quiet and make sure that she can tell the story to her grandkids about her father dying. So I mean, it's really based on that. And when I was recording the song in studio, I've since not performed the song because it's just difficult to relive that moment.
I feel
somehow so many people have resonated because so many of these kind of stories, especially in KZN in the 80s, like the mid to late 80s, Emagongo in particular, so people were going through a lot of this. So I thought I have to just confront my fears and I have to confront my trauma and maybe perhaps, you know, open a space for other people to sort of heal. But it's not really an easy moment to relive or to even think about.
Yeah. But that is art, I guess. Isn't that the art? It's taking the trauma that's happening internally and externalizing that stuff for it to be able to reflect on itself.
That's precisely. Yeah. It's exactly that.
Sure.
Yeah.
What an amazing journey you've been through, honestly, to see the, like I say, I keep bringing this up, the humility of your music and how you focus on the craft and telling these amazing stories. Yeah. What is the role of mentorship in an industry like this, especially in the world of music? Because you played sort of backup piano for some of the most prolific artists in South Africa and, you know, the legends and icons of the music industry.
Sure.
What role did that play in your growth journey?
Yeah. So throughout my career, I see myself as a disciple. So a disciple is someone who follows a particular way of thinking. But also beyond that, they carry a responsibility to echo a particular voice. Mm. So I've been a disciple of Mambusi Mhlongo, for instance, of Zim Ngawana, of Begin Selegu. Mm. And but then the responsibility is how do we then echo these messages? Mm. And I find this to be an ancient African practice. So when we think about the West, we think about teacher and student. But then I was just saying, almost making some sort of a joke, that if you're learning in an institution, in the Western sort of outlook of what that means, for instance, you don't have to walk like your lecturer. But as a disciple, if he limps, then you have to sort of, you know, imitate all of that. So I was doing this tribute to a great master, Begim Selegu, who really influenced me a lot. And so it's really towards that, like, how do we then remember an ancestor? Mm-hmm. And writers like John Beattie, for example, argue that in African thinking, an ancestor can only live in the ancestral realm for as long as people still call their name.
Yeah.
So as people chant their name. Mm-hmm. So there is a need over and above doing these particular rituals, which are maybe once a year, or imsebenzi, which may be 5 years, but there is a need to constantly create a mantra of these ancestors and different modes at which we can start remembering them. Yeah. One is playing their music. Mm. You know, when last did we hear a Zim Ngawana song, for instance? And I mean, before the gig that I just did at the Market Theatre, remembering Mselegu, how often do you hear Mselegu on radio? So there is a need to take that initiative and carry that responsibility of being a disciple. And sometimes to also leave some of what you want to do for a moment and just remember the ones that came before you. And it's quite an important thing. And I think there is no pressure for me, for example, to have a voice. But if I can get a chance to echo the voices of the ones that came before me, and I think that's more important because then I can be remembered for that, as opposed to my very own work, but for how we reimagine other people's work.
Stunning. Mm. Hopefully the generations to come will continue to play your music as well and will continue to share work for the millennials. Listen, there's so much still to come on the show. We have a live performance coming up as well, so make sure that you guys don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Our guests on Afternoon Express fly domestically with Mango. Enjoy outstanding service, online check-in and seat selection. With the widest booking and payment options, Mango is the only airline globally to accept store charge cards as a means of payment. Fly in comfort with ergonomically efficient seats for more legroom aboard a fleet of new generation Boeing 737-800 aircraft. Join the guests of Afternoon Express and fly Mango.
squeaking, not moving.
Oh, it's this one. On this song.
Ah, okay.
I'll try it. Now I'm conscious of it.
Whoa, mama, mama, Africa. Is that okay?
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. It's a Friday. We have a legend with us in the loft today. Makhathini has been described as a musician who plays with a bright lyricism. The next song, Mama Africa, is a tribute to Miriam Makeba, the continent of Africa, and the mothers of the world. It's a great way to celebrate the role women play in society, especially this Women's Month. It's amazing.
So
honestly.
Beautiful.
Yeah. I just wish you guys could have been here in the loft with us today just to be able to experience what it's like to see crew, everyone else behind the scenes, just so engrossed in something. That's when you know music can transform you and you know you're talented.
Yeah, what beautiful. A great show and what a great start to the weekend. Now, make sure you tune in again next week, Monday, when we have all the winners of Presenter Search on 3 in our loft, including our brand new presenter, Palesa Tembe.
It's going to be awesome. What are your plans for the weekend? Excited?
Oh, yeah. I'm shooting a campaign for my new gin.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, I'm very
so we have to taste them all before the shoots happen. We know that's going to happen. Hope you guys have a great weekend this weekend. Catch Afternoon Express next week, Monday through to Friday. Hop us forward to Hop Past 5. We love you. Thanks for joining in on the conversation. Hashtag Afternoon Express. Don't do what we wouldn't do, all right? Good night.
Ciao.
Made with love by Clover.
Another feel-good production.